They believe in the Day of Judgment. Now, this is really important because this is a hallmark of Muslims. They believe in the Day of Judgment. And Qadi Abu Bakr, going back to him, he has a chapter on Yawm al-Hisab, the Day of Reckoning. The muhasib is like the accountant. Every business has an accountant, and that accountant hopefully is making sure that your income is greater than your outcome. And so the Day of Judgment is the day when we have the tabulation of our life on earth, and everything will be recorded. It's all being recorded. And so we come on that day, and that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they believe in the last day. And then it says, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ عَذَابِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ, that they have fear of their Lord's punishment. So even though they're believers, they don't feel secure. Like Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu said that, if I had one foot in paradise and one foot out of paradise, I still would not feel secure until I was firmly in paradise. And so this is something that the believers have, that they actually have a sense of the momentousness, the awe of that day. And there's a hadith from Abu Huraira where the Prophet ﷺ said that on that day, Allah will meet his servant. فَيَقُولُ أَيْفُلْ, hey, so-and-so, أَلَمْ أُكْرِمْكَ وَأُسَوِّدْكَ وَأَذَرْكَ تَرْأَسُ وَتَرْتَعَ, didn't I honor you? Didn't I give you a position? Didn't I leave you to enjoy life? فَيَقُولُ بَلَى, if indeed you did. فَيَقُولُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَفَظَنَنْتَ أَنَّكَ مُلَاقِيَ, did you think you were going to meet me? قَالَ فَيَقُولُ لَا, no. فَيَقُولُ فَإِنِّي أَنْسَاكَ كَمَا نَسِيتَنِ, today I forget you just as you had forgotten me. Right? كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَةُ فَنَسِيتَهَا فَالْيَوْمُ تُنْسَى. The Quran reminds us that the verses come to them and they forgot them, so on that day they're forgotten. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them. And then the second he says, وَأُسَخِرْ لَكَ الْخَيْلَ وَالْإِبْلِ, didn't I give you wealth, camels and horses? ثُمَّ يُلْقِيَ الثَّالِثُ فَيَقُولُ لَهُ مِثْلَ ذَا, and then the next one comes and the next one. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, اقْرَ كِتَابَكَ كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا, read your book, the book of your deeds, and suffice your own soul as your reckoner. Because the human being knows, in insana ala nafsi basira, human beings know what they've done. وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَذِيرًا, even if he gives all of his excuses. So then for the believer, right, he gets the hisab. And then when he sees his situation, he thinks, I'm going to perish unless I get the sabiqa of the husna from Allah, the grace from God. And then wudi'at lahu la ilaha illallah fi kiffat al-mizan. And then his word la ilaha illallah is put in the other scale, so his deeds are in the scale, and then it puts la ilaha, and it outweighs everything. Farajahat lahu samawat wal ard, is more weightier than the heavens and the earth. And so this is a great gift to the believers. But this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about that day, that they believe in the last day. They believe in the Yawm al-Hisab, and they're preparing for it. The Prophet ﷺ used to do death remembrance every day. And he said, أَكْثِرُ مِنْ ذِكْرِ هَذَمَ اللَّذَّاتِ, do much remembrance of the destroyer of pleasure. Because much of life is mata'. It's in, I mean, we have our tribulations, but we also have a great deal of enjoyment and food and companionship and wealth and security and homes and all these things that Allah has given us. These are great blessings. But there is a reckoning. There is a hisab. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. And then he reminds us, Inna adhaba rabbihim ghayru mamun. They're not secure from that punishment. Nobody should feel secure. And that's why nalinsana khuliqa halu'a, that human beings panic when trials come to them. They lose it. There's people that lose their faith. But then you have to question, did they have faith in the first place? Because the whole purpose of faith is to get you through all those difficulties. I mean, the word in Arabic for believer is mu'min, billah, the one who secures himself with God. I mean, if you took it literally, amana bi is to secure, to give yourself aman with God. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمَنُ, They are secure. Those people are in a state of security who believe and don't commit shirk. They're in a state of security. And so then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ, those who protect their private parts. And that means that they protect their private parts except in the confines of marriage, in lawful sexual relations. Because sexual relations outside of what God has permitted, it leads to لَا تَقَرْبُ زِنَا إِنْهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَا وَسَأَ السَّبِيلَ. Do not go near adultery or fornication. The Arabs have one word for it, zina. Because it's an obscenity, it's foul, it's a fahisha. وَسَأَ السَّبِيلَ, and it takes you down a terrible way. And all you have to do is Google the statistics on STDs and on all the things that happen to people who transgress these hudud. تِلْكَ حُدُودُ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَعْتَدُوهَا. These are the hudud of God, so don't go beyond them. Because the hudud are there to protect us. This is God's mercy towards us. It's not anything else. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's His mercy towards us. And so this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that they guard their private parts. إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِمْ أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ. That's not blameworthy if it's rightful and lawful. فَمِنِ ابْتَغَى وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ. And those who go beyond that, they are the transgressors. They go, عَادُونَ. They have transgressed the limits. And those limits are not just moral limits, they're biological limits, and they will have repercussions. One of the tragedies is this loss of a sense of chastity and the importance of a female guarding the virtue of chastity. Because the great virtue of a woman is chastity. This is not sexist, it's not to say this. There's nothing wrong with saying this. Because a woman is far more susceptible to venereal diseases than a man is, just because of the nature of the epithelial lining. And this is why the STDs amongst women are much higher. They don't tell them that. And it's a crime to these poor girls that think that they can be promiscuous and go about and do these things like some men do and not suffer the same consequences. No, it's much worse. It's worse for them. And it's bad for men. And chastity is a virtue for men as well as women. But women traditionally guarded that. The women of the Arabian Peninsula, sometimes when they were taken from tribes would come, they would raid other tribes and defeat them and take the women as captives. The women would throw themselves off and break their necks because they did not want a man to take them. And this happens. There's cultures where women do this. I mean, it's a tragedy. I mean, the Rape of the Sabines is one of the great masterpieces of Western art. It's horrible. When things break down, it's the women who suffer. And that's why if you have a society where you say masculinity is toxic, where you take away men's chivalry and the idea that they're there to defend women and children, when you remove that concept from them, that will work temporarily in a culture that has still a civil society. But when things break down, look what happens. Who suffers? Who suffer? Everybody suffers, but the ones that suffer the most are the women and children. And if you don't believe me, just ask the poor Yazidi girls about what happened to them. Where were the chivalrous men then? Where were the men that should have come and rescued those poor women from the horrors of war and the pillaging and horrible bestial ravaging of men that should not even be entitled to the name man? And even to call them a beast would be unfair. Demons are the only word that is appropriate for people like that. Demons. Because even animals don't do these things. Animals take what they need and they leave the rest. Have you ever watched those animal channels? Like they'll show like the lion and then all the zebras will run. But then they catch one zebra and then they all go back to eating. Because they know the lion's not, it's not like a man who comes in there and just kills everybody. The lion just takes what it needs. They say, oh, you know, poor Herbert, he's lunch today for the lion, but we're all okay. And that's what happens in the animal kingdom. But humans, no, they gloat in the ability to inflict cruelty.